we're looking at rain chances picking up again on Wednesday. Just a few scattered showers and storms, and they would really roll into a very wet weather pattern. Several waves of rain and thunder starting on Thursday, maxing out Saturday and Sunday. It should be a very soggy weekend with 1 to 3 inches of rain common.
5:23, Chief Meteorologist James Abeloff. News this morning, not much damage was done when someone set fire to a church in 61st and Peoria early this morning.
The guy down here told me that it looks like someone busted out the window, tied up a few things inside, and then it set them on fire. This church building is empty right now. It doesn't have too much damage. The firefighters are calling this arson.
5:23 in Fairview, Preston Jones reporting. Updating now the war on terror, NBC News reports the Pentagon is considering a plan to allow U.S. military airstrikes against ISIS in the Philippines. Armed drones would carry out the targeted strikes in the southern islands. From Manila, Secretary of State Rex Tillerson says the U.S. is already providing the Philippines government with intelligence to aid in the fight against ISIS. Back here in Tulsa, stabbing victim's girlfriend is a witness, but must convince the victim to go to the hospital. Both police were called after she took him to the hall near 55th and South Loop.
He had non-life-threatening injuries, but still, some pretty good operations to his side.
The man was stabbed by a man with a knife near Independence Street in North Utica around 2 this morning. Witnesses identified the suspect, but he has not yet been arrested. This morning, we are getting a look at emails that have recently surfaced showing one member of former President Obama's administration using a fake name.
You know that former attorney general Loretta Lynch, but according to the government email address, she's Elizabeth Carlisle.